CG with the heat.
Ladies and gentlemen, good late afternoon, evening. It is your boy LBFWA, and once again back with another banger with yet another video. It's been, like I said, it's been a minute because I've been mostly doing lives. I'm glad to be back. Once again, Merry Christmas to all, first of all. Second of all, I just want to give my analysis really quick on Celtics and Raptors and the Bucks and Sixers. Starting with the Celtics and the Raptors, I think that with Boston, they did an excellent job establishing themselves on the road against Toronto. Toronto looked like they played hard, but they looked a little bit tired, man, from coming back down from 30 against the Mavericks and against coming back from double digits against the Pacers. But once again, you don't make excuses. I mean, Boston played who was in front of them. You know, the Celtics, they were without Marcus Smart. But the Raptors are missing Pascal Siakam, Norman Powell, and Marc Gasol. But it just shows you that the Raptors are a legit basketball team. So they've kept their culture. And, shout out to Toronto Raptors fans, we're the North. And shout out to Boston Celtics fans, and shout out to the Boston Celtics for getting it done. They're now 21-7. So shout out to them. Now on the Bucks versus Philadelphia 76ers game. Do not count on the Philadelphia 76ers making 21 threes, because they are near the bottom of the league in three-pointers made, and they're also near the bottom of the league in percentage. I think they're 24th in makes at 10.8 per game. They ended up making 21, so they were hot from three. They moved the ball really well, and the Bucks' defense was not great. But if you watch Giannis Antetokounmpo, when I watch him, once again, this to me is a case of Giannis has become, and the Bucks have kind of become, the Cavaliers of these new Cavaliers of the Eastern Conference, and here's why. Even though Mike Budenholzer has a system, the problem is they play to the strengths of Giannis Antetokounmpo. And if you look at the way Embiid played him, Embiid did a great job using his body. He kept putting his hands up, and he kept building walls on Giannis every time Giannis made his move. And when Giannis would go up, Embiid would use his arms to shield him, to stop Giannis's momentum, and then he would strip him on the way down. And so Giannis was turning the ball over like crazy. They would also send a second defender when Giannis would make his move to the basket. They also would build two to three guys and build a wall, so they were clogging the paint. They were just building a brick wall. And so Giannis had to pass that ball up. And they basically said, Giannis, you have to beat us on the outside. Also, the Sixers did a great job in limiting the Bucks from getting in transition, because you can see that the Bucks have a difficult time in the half court when you take away their transition baskets. And also they were missing Eric Bledsoe because he can push the tempo, and they were missing that. You notice that the Bucks are not as explosive on the break when Eric Bledsoe is not in the lineup. He pushes the pace off of misses and off of turnovers. That's why it's important to know that the Bucks were missing him. But this is why right now, I just don't think, as well as the Bucks have played in the regular season, I just feel like they're a regular season team. They got to prove it to me in the playoffs. I give credit for them playing the way they have. But if they plan to play this style of play, playing to Giannis' strengths, I don't see the Bucks going far and winning a championship. Because if you look at the Sixers, the Raptors, the Celtics, they have bodies they can throw at Giannis Antetokounmpo. They can build a wall on Giannis Antetokounmpo. That's why from now to hopefully by playoff time, Giannis's jump shot had better be consistent. And if you notice the way Giannis holds the ball, he holds it at a certain angle to where that's why he doesn't have enough arc on his jump shot, and he has a little hitch on his release. So if he could fix those mechanics, Giannis would definitely be better. And you notice, look how many tough shots Giannis took in this game. So it doesn't matter if Giannis is improved. The game plan doesn't change for these teams. Build a wall, and you need to prove you can beat us from the outside. And stay at home with the shooters. Pretty much. So ladies and gentlemen, those are the first two games. I'm hoping this Laker-Clipper game is lit tonight. I mean, because with the Rockets and the Warriors and the Pelicans and the Nuggets, I'm looking at these games as kind of a wash, in my opinion. But that's just my opinion. Let me know what you guys think. Stay tuned with me and D on the LBFWN as we come back with that Lakers-Clippers game, man. Yo, it's going to be a lit one, hopefully, man. Bron and AD are expected to play, so just giving you guys the news. So Ladies and gentlemen, this was your boy Lewis back with another one. LBFWN. Say it with your chest 3 times, ladies and gentlemen. Say it with me. Live, laugh, love. Thank you for watching my reaction video, man. See y'all at 8 p.m. Lakers and Clippers. Let's get it, baby. Like, subscribe, and make sure to share the video.